Hello everybody, Jeremy with AltRider. We're going to do the Tail Tidy installation for the Yamaha Tenere 700. This is actually an easy installation. It's just long and a lot of fasteners to remove and bodywork, but otherwise, as far as the technical aspect, it's pretty straightforward, even including if you do the optional LED blinkers. Things to note though about the Tail Tidy that you get with AltRider, we were able to successfully get the finite analysis to allow us to do this in aluminum. So we really reduced the weight, but the way we were able to do it is with a simple gusset. It seems really trivial, but it's that simple gusset that makes this flange over 30% stronger and able to sustain the aggressive off-road riding and not fail. So it's a big upgrade and an option to pay attention to.
You gotta love it.
You've got the option to select the Cyclops. This is revision 3. So it's the option in addition with the Tail Tidy, and you'll get their full LED blinker kit, which is the more robust on the stalks. And then they've got some updated functionality in terms of the daytime running lights. So you get the blinker plates and you get the updated flasher for the LEDs. That's when you select the Cyclops kit. The AltRider Tail Tidy, you receive, of course, your textured powder coat Tail Tidy for any 10 millimeter blinker stock. And then if ordered direct, you get Loctite resealable. And then you've got 4 fasteners, and then you have 4 of washers. And then you've got the 4 larger diameter washers that go to the underside. And then we've got the 2 nylon zip ties. The tools that we're gonna need. Okay, to get started, a lot of you guys are gonna already have the AltRider luggage rack. So we'll start by removing that one, and of course just do the reverse of your instructions, and then we'll get started taking off the bodywork. We went ahead and removed the AltRider rear rack. Now we're able to get started, so we're gonna go ahead and pull the seat. As you guys may or may not know by now, once you pull your seat, you then have this bolt system that's holding your seat down. So we'll grab our M4 driver, and we'll back off the bolts for the seat. And of course these ones we're gonna keep contained because we're going to be reinstalling the seat. Now we've got the seats off, start with our cargo hold downs, or if you've got any sort of a rack system. With T40s, we're going to pull these luggage spindles. So now we'll pull the mid panel with our T30. The nice thing is Yamaha's updated its fasteners to resemble the KTMs, so you can grab it with either an M8 or T30. Torx 30. And we'll do the same on the other side. And again, we're saving these fasteners. Make sure you maintain that rubber grommet in there. Should be fine, but sometimes they can actually stick and pop off, so just a little attention to detail there. And again, we'll put these with the seat. Now we're ready to take off the rear fairing, and we've got the plastic detent, the little plastic rivet, and so we'll push those in, and then that guy will release. So once you push that guy all the way in, you see that it's released, and then we'll reuse it. So by pushing it in, allows the rivet to compress. We'll drop that on both sides. Then we've got 5 of our button heads at the top that are M4 Allens. And then we've got 3 fasteners on the bottom side, each as Torx 30. So let's go ahead and get started. And as you guys are pulling the button heads, be sure to contain the shouldered washer so it doesn't crush your plastic fairing when you reassemble. Again, 5 bolts, 5 shouldered washers, M4 Allen. Now we'll jump to the underside, go to a Torx 30 driver. And we'll do the same for the other side. Now with all the fasteners removed, you can flare out your plastic fairing, and there's a catch tab, so make sure not to lose the little rubber catch, and you slide backwards and the rear fairing comes off. Okay, so now we're gonna unbolt the rear taillight. We've got the 2 acorn fasteners here. So with a 10 millimeter spanner or wrench, go ahead and break those loose. And we'll walk these guys off. And you've got a washer underneath the acorn nut. Make sure you grab that. And then over here, I've got the 1 zip tie holding the OEM harness. So I'm gonna clip that so that I can get that off. And be careful of your harness is that's in there tight, so making sure that you're just grabbing the zip tie. So there are those washers that want to stick. So again, guys, small detail, just be sure you're gonna grab those guys because they'll stick. So now following that harness, come over to the other side here. We've got our wiring harness freed. We've got the two blinkers, the license plate light, and then our tail light. On our white clip here, of course you can push it down here, but sometimes it needs extra assistance. So if you've got a pick, that's really helpful. And then you can start to walk the catch down and get this guy to release. You guys see the little clip there, you'll want to push down, you'll get that guy to release. Now we can walk our tail light out, and then we've got the shoulder washers that sit inside the grommet. Let's make sure not to lose these, and we'll set this entire assembly off to the side. Now that we got the tail light out, let's go ahead and disconnect our blinker, and they're inverted, the right and left hand side, so you don't have to worry about hooking up right or left incorrectly. And again, as we said, the black designates that that's the license plate light. All right, let's continue on with our disassembly. Pull that that zip tie, we'll replace that. Okay guys, at this stage, we're now ready to take off a lot of the fasteners of this tail section. Again, as you know, it's a pretty heavy plastic laden part. So we'll need an M5 and our T30, and we'll start stripping these fasteners. And this is what's getting us to dramatic weight loss, going to that aluminum tail tidy with those gusseted flanges, so we've got that stronger setup. So I'm gonna start right out of the gate. I'll go to the M5 that gets these two Allens out of the way. And then now I'm gonna switch to my T30. And I've got these four. And then now I'm just gonna grab the four remaining bolts that are holding the remainder of the tail tidy on. And grab a hold of the system as it's now gonna be free. At this stage, you are able to pull the top bracket off, feed the wires through, and that gives us the opportunity to now take the taillight bracket that we're gonna use. So now I'm gonna swap back to my T30 driver. And we're able to grab our bracket. Set that aside. And now we'll work on the disassembly of the taillight to receive the license plate light. So we've got more zip ties holding our harness. And again, guys, just take your time because it's close to the wiring harness. Now we have the three T30s. And then we've got the two 10s, and that'll take that sub-assembly off. We've got washers behind those nuts. So now that takes off that bracket, which now we flip it over, and now we've got one more of our Torx 30. We'll release that backing plate. Here we are. So now we're down to the two, it is an 8mm. We've got washers and then shoulder spacers for the rubber grommets. So we'll make sure we grab all of those. We'll grab this last zip tie. Just careful as you're pulling out that license plate light. I've got my two spacers here, and now I can retrieve my washers and the two nuts. Let's feed the wiring through these sub-assemblies, and now we have our license plate taillight. Again, guys, keep an eye on those shouldered spacers for the rubber grommet. Real easy, let's go ahead and salvage these grommets for the license plate light. And now, because we're using the Cyclops LEDs, we're done with this assembly. If you're using some other off-the-shelf LED blinkers, you can always salvage these for the connectors if you needed to. But otherwise, we're done with this assembly. And this assembly, Okay, now that we're ready to start the reassembly, I went ahead and laid everything out that we're reusing. Here's the tail light from the Yamaha, and we'll get the orientation correct when we install it. We've got those shouldered spacers, the washers, those acorn nuts. Those were the ones you saved. Then the license plate light. We've got the shouldered washers, the rubber grommets, the regular washers, and then the 8mm nuts that's gonna go on there. And then this is the bracket that we're reusing with the original grommets that will hold the tail light, and then the original OEM hardware. We've got our Tail Tidy, the AltRider hardware kit, and then if you've purchased the Cyclops lighting system, we'll go ahead and do that installation of the rear blinkers. The front's really straightforward, and the flasher relay is there as well for the LED versus the incandescents. Or if you're using your own 10mm LED, you can install according to those instructions. So let's get started. Okay guys, we'll start with the license plate light. I'm going to first install my grommets. These are really soft grommets, so you really don't need any lubrication. Go ahead and get the grooves set in there, and you can work it from the back side. Okay, then I can go ahead and set the shoulder spacers in first. I want to feed the power supply through. And then bring our license plate light in line. Then we'll go to the washers, and then the nuts, and then I need an 8mm driver. And these don't need Loctite, guys, because they are Loctite versions. They're not Nylox. They've got the steel to keep them from coming loose. So as we get ready to put on the tail light holder, we want to make sure we just get the orientation correct, and that's that tab that the rear fairing is going to hold on. So this tab is facing to the rear. When we disassembled, it didn't have Loctite, but just a good habit, guys. So I'm going to go ahead and just get some of that Loctite that was supplied with you when you ordered from AltRider. You'll note, see the shouldered spacer? That shouldered spacer will help locate that tail light because that will drop into the aluminum shoulder of the Tail Tidy. So as I get that going, I make sure that this gets aligned, and then you see that, guys, how that drops down. So make sure you get the shouldered bolts to align and then drop down, and that's, now I'm ready to tighten. You see that, guys? That shoulder will locate this bracket perfectly. And it's these small, subtle details that really pay off. That seems fairly trivial, but to get the geometry just correct so that the bolt hole centers and the shoulders then locate that taillight holder in the perfect place is one of the small details that you just won't find with some of the other options on the market. So now we're gonna start with the taillight. I'm gonna make sure I get my shoulder spacers, if I've taken them out, back into the bracket. And this tail light geometry is a little confusing. So one way to easy is just make sure that the single OEM spacer is pointing downward. These are gonna be facing upward, and feed that power supply through there. And now from the back side, again, reusing those OEM washers and the acorn nuts. Let's get that all positioned. And this is a 10mm driver for this side. So now we're gonna jump to the blinkers. Again, on this install, we're using the Cyclops version 3.0. So let's go ahead and, we need to get the backing nuts off. And so that means we've gotta separate the posi taps. The blue is if you want to have the rear blinkers work with the running lights, which we don't recommend. This is then the power for the tail lights. So I'm gonna separate this power for the blinker. So I need to separate that posi tap so I can separate my blinker wires and pull off the backing nut that is a 14mm nut. And of course, be smart when you guys tighten these back down. So I'll get both fed off so we can put these onto the Tail Tidy. So now that we've got our stems ready to go, we can even get these started, and I'll cover a few pieces about the version 3.0 on the blinkers. So we'll get these all fed through, and I'll grab my nut, grab my other one, because I'm going to want to Loctite that stem. Okay, so one of the things that, you know, Cyclops Daryl told us, hey, you guys, be really careful you don't strip these threaded out. So one of the things you can do is just go ahead and give yourself just a little bit of blue Loctite, and these just need to be snugged up. They've had problems with guys over-torquing these things. You've even got the back of the nuts, of course, are serrated. See that, guys? You've seen that on our skid plates. That's to help to keep those from ever backing off. So now we've got a little bit of blue Loctite on there. I'll grab my 14 millimeter wrench and we'll just snug these guys up. And then we'll talk about the lighting functionality that the options we have when we do our wiring. So again, guys, just snugging these up, do not over torque these. You'll pull them out of their overmold, the threaded stock. We've got that little stand out there for our wiring. Keep the tail light, that's going to flow right through back into the fairing, but what I wanted to do is secure both of my blinkers and the license plate light and make sure you're not on the wire but you're back up on the sheath. So I'm going to slide that sheathing back. There we go. And just good etiquette, get that guy tucked in there. Now we're going to zip tie our two blinkers and our license plate light, keeping the tail light free. And you could have done this before you put your tail light on. It can make it a little bit easier. But so I feed that through and come back through. And make sure, guys, that we have all of the sheathing is tucked back, and that's the only part that we want to clamp down on. And this is replacing essentially that OEM zip tie that we took off of the plastic bodywork. And then we'll just snug that down. And then if you've ever been around anybody setting up dock car bikes, these are flat dikes, so that means there's only a blade on one side. And the nice thing what that does is that leaves your zip tie flush and you don't have that known barb or the trimming of the nylon in a place where it's going to cut your knuckles. So that's all nicely tucked in there. And we'll bring that back up and around. And then before we take this over to the bike, let's go ahead and prep the power supply for our Cyclops blinkers. And we've got two elements of functionality now with the version 3.0. If we wanted the blinkers to stay on as running lights, you would hook up the blue power supply, but we don't recommend that because you don't get as bold of a transition for your brake light, which is the red. And if we only hook up the red, we will now get a scrolling or a sequential sequence of two red and then a very bright flash of red that stays illuminated when you pull the rear brake. Otherwise, to clarify again, if we have both supplies hooked up, blue and red, the blue is your running light. So that means that you have a red light it's a dimmer function than what your tail light is at, but you don't get that dramatic transition when you pull the brake if you're running the running lights. So we recommend to just hook up the red power feeds on the posi tap, and that will then allow the blinkers to function both as my tail light and my blinker in a more substantial fashion. You guys still have the option on version 3.0 to hook up the blue as a running light in addition. And then we need to start and go get our original posi tap. We'll take off the black side, and you see you have the pin, and you have then the receiver side. We'll go to our tail light power feed, and we want to identify the yellow connector, and I'm going to run that through there. And what's going to end up happening is, as I thread that down, you see the pin is going to make just the nice pierce through that OEM wire sheath, and then that's going to supply the signal power for the brake light. So I go ahead and I tighten that down. Again, those are only plastic threads, so don't need to overdo it. Now I'm going to bring back my red, bring both of them together, twist these guys together, I want to make sure that I even up the wire sheath, twist these together, and then I'm going to feed them into the other side of that posi tap and then go get my cap. Oops. So then now that I've got those together, feed that down right to the bottom of where the wire was stripped back to. Now on the other side does not have the pin but has the threaded portion. Drop that in and around, and I like to make that go just around that pin. And then I'm going to feed that onto there. And again, these are only plastic threads, so you don't need to overdo it. And now that we've decided not to run the blue, I'm just going to close that back off to the original posi tap that was supplied from Cyclops. So same idea, I'll twist this together. Go grab my posi tap cap. And then here it is with the black just sealed up. We'll drop that on there. And then that'll keep that contained. And now we're ready to take this over to the bike for installation. Because we're going to be putting the luggage rack system back on, I'm not going to drive the fasteners on immediately because I have to then have my luggage rack brackets. So what I'll do is I'll use the bodywork and the wiring harness to help support this until I can get my fasteners in place. And so you see that locates right there, and then that'll just support everything. And we'll come onto this side and we'll finish our wiring. Here is left-hand side because it's the female, right-hand side black because it's the female. And that's where it's really nice and easy. So there's my blinkers and the sides identified. And then my license plate light is the only male. So that's really straightforward and easy. So my blinker goes left-hand side to gray, right-hand side to black. License plate light, easy to identify, can't get that wrong. Our tail light. Again, guys, I'm gonna make sure I tuck it in. This is exactly how we disassembled it, you know, before I come to my clip, so that this is all nice and tidy. And we gave you an extra zip tie, so I'm gonna tidy this up and then hit this with one zip tie. So not necessary, but because we got extra slack with the blinker system and then to secure the posi tap wires, we gave you that extra zip tie, and then you can just, I like to tidy everything up. And then before we put the bodywork back on, I want to put the Cyclops flasher in. So I'm going to identify the OEM Yamaha flasher. It's on that rubber boot on that peg. I'm going to take that connector off, push pin. We've got the jumper connected, and this will also work for the front blinker as well. And then he gives you the 3M DuraLock, and I like to put it, you prep this with alcohol and clean that same surface, and then locate it right into there. And I'll put my tabs facing down, the wire prongs, for a nice Sano installation. Now we've got all the wiring done, and you can take a quick second and actually check. This is a good time to make sure you got the left and the right done correctly. Trust me, guys, it's worth taking the 1 second to make sure you did your wiring correct and that your brake light is functioning in the blinkers as well. Now we grab the rear fairing. Remember the locator, we want to catch it onto the tab here. So I just flex that over, and then I slide it on forward, and then I'm looking to locate those five fasteners at the top. Remember those fancy brass spacers? Again, like with all your plastic bodywork, that's what these shouldered spacers and or shouldered bolts are for. So I want to put that shoulder facing down, and that's going to take up the gap of the plastic. So get all five of those started and snugged down. And that's an M4 Allen key. So now we've got our six, and these are those shouldered again that are going to go along the bottom here. And I found that it is best to just get this one started first. That's what I found is the best sequence to do. So then start here, just do it sequentially and get them just started before you snug them down, and it'll make it much easier to get the installation done. So again, on this other side, I'm gonna get all three started and then I'll come back and snug them down. Okay, now I got them all started. I'm gonna snug all these down. And again, don't over torque these guys. They're just on those clip nuts. And then before we put our center bodywork on, don't forget those plastic pop rivets. So get those started. And now we're gonna grab our center bodywork to make sure that rubber grommet's in place. And then I'm gonna pop that on. And then out of these three fasteners, the black was in the front. And you got a little pin that locates back there as well. Rubber grommet into here. You've got that pin. That pin goes into that bodywork. Little details, guys. Black goes up to the front. And then we'll do the two silver screws into the rear. And we'll move on to putting the luggage rack on. Okay, so now we're ready to install the hardware that's gonna hold the Tail Tidy up. If you didn't have the AltRider luggage rack installed, you could jump and start right to this before you put your bodywork on. I've set the smaller washers on all four of the screws. I'm gonna do a drop or two of Loctite for each one of my screws. And then I have my larger washers, M5 driver. We'll take a larger washer over. And these are to address the factory spacer. If I was not installing the AltRider luggage rack, I would just install the large washer over the shoulder that's on the OEM subframe. And when I'm putting my AltRider luggage rack back on, make sure you guys have the carriage bolts in place. Because I'm doing the AltRider luggage rack, I'll have this, and we'll make sure to center that over top of the shouldered spacers. So I walk my AltRider luggage rack into place, get this started, and essentially what we're identifying is to create the tension so that the Tail Tidy will be snug tight in between the luggage rack and that shouldered spacer. So I'll get these all started, but making sure that the large washer sits around the outside of the shoulder so we can get good compression on the Tail Tidy. So again, on this other side, I'll get my larger washer in place and get this guy started. And we're just gonna get them snugged so that that allows us to be able to slide the washer in on my rear fasteners. So I'll get those started. And now I've got plenty of gap to be able to slide that guy in. Here, now that we're snugging this up, wanna make sure that this large washer ends up centered on those standoffs. This is a subtle but critical detail. So you see how that fat washer is tucked inward. He's not centered as you're seeing the three others. And the problem is, even when it's completely tightened, you still will be able to have that subtle amount of flex. And with this being an aluminum design, you need to ensure that you actually take the time to orient the four fat washers so they're over the spacer. It's much easier when you don't have the luggage rack installed, and this is a one-time install. But so now I need to walk that washer back over with a flat blade or a pick and make sure that he is able to create compression. And you see now how stable that platform is. And so it's a subtle detail, guys, but take your time to make sure you get that dialed and correct. Because we don't want any amount of movement is what's gonna introduce the failure over time, which is true all over the motorcycle, any part of accessory or aftermarket. Okay, finish putting on your luggage rack the same as you did your other instructions. You've got your X brace and then the top plate. Again, guys, make sure you tighten the nuts, not the stainless steel flatheads, for the final torque. If you had the AltRider luggage rack, that's all installed. Now we wanna put these luggage rack cargo spindles on. remember that OEM seat with the M4 Allen. Drive home that OEM seat. And then if you've got a pillion seat, great. If you've got the AltRider pillion, go ahead and drop that on. And then to close, guys, you're just gonna install your license plate. But one tip we recommend is utilizing these plastic license plate butt bolt and nut. You get these from your dealer. It's just one more added way to keep the weight down. So go ahead and just wrap up by installing your license plate to your new Tail Tidy, and then you're done. Not an overly complicated install. So if you've got any questions, reach out to us, but hope you guys really like the design and the option to pick up the Cyclops blinkers, and let us know if you have any questions or concerns.